We all know about this famous scene.
It's one small step for man, one giant leap for mankind.
But not many know that after this mission, humans have been on the moon 5 more times. In this video, we bring you the stories of every manned mission to the moon, what they did there, and what fascinating things they discovered. Apollo 11 was the first successful manned mission to the moon, and it took place in July of 1969. The mission was commanded by astronaut Neil Armstrong, with Buzz Aldrin and Michael Collins as the other two crew members. The Apollo 11 spacecraft consisted of a command module, the cockpit, and a lunar module, which would land on the moon. After a successful launch and a journey of 3 days, the lunar module, with Armstrong and Aldrin inside, descended to the surface of the moon. Armstrong became the first person to step onto the moon, famously declaring,
"It's one small step for man, one giant leap for mankind."
During their time on the moon, Armstrong and Aldrin spent about 21 hours outside of the lunar module, conducting experiments and collecting rock and soil samples. They also planted the American flag on the surface. The mission was a huge triumph for the United States and demonstrated their technological superiority in the Cold War space race against the Soviet Union. The experiments and samples collected during the mission provided valuable information about the moon's history and composition. For example, the samples showed that the moon was formed from debris created by a massive impact between the Earth and another celestial body, and that the moon's surface is covered in a layer of fine dust called regolith. The Apollo 11 mission marked a major milestone in human history and sparked renewed interest in space exploration. It remains one of the most impressive achievements of human technology and is widely celebrated as a triumph of human spirit and determination. Apollo 12 was the second manned mission to the moon and took place in November of 1969, just 4 months after the successful Apollo 11 mission. The crew of Apollo 12 consisted of Commander Charles Conrad, Lunar Module Pilot Alan Bean, and Command Module Pilot Richard Gordon. One of the main goals of the Apollo 12 mission was to perform a more precise landing on the moon, and to explore a different area of the lunar surface than the Apollo 11 mission. The crew successfully accomplished this goal by landing their lunar module in the Ocean of Storms, a vast plain of dark, volcanic rock. During their stay on the moon, Conrad and Bean conducted 2 moonwalks and collected rock and soil samples. They also set up experiments to study the lunar environment, including a package of scientific instruments called the ALSEP, Apollo Lunar Surface Experiments Package, that measured seismic activity and the magnetic field of the moon. One of the most significant moments of the Apollo 12 mission was when Bean and Conrad found and visited the Surveyor 3 spacecraft, which had landed on the moon 2.5 years earlier. The astronauts were able to bring back parts of the Surveyor as well as valuable information about the condition of the spacecraft and its impact on the surrounding environment. The samples collected and experiments performed during the Apollo 12 mission added to our understanding of the moon's geology and history. For example, the data gathered helped scientists determine the age of the moon and provided evidence of past volcanic activity on its surface. Apollo 14 was the third successful manned mission to the moon, and it took place in January of 1971. The crew of Apollo 14 consisted of Commander Alan Shepard, Lunar Module Pilot Edgar Mitchell, and Command Module Pilot Stuart Roosa. One of the main goals of the Apollo 14 mission was to perform a more extensive exploration of the moon's surface, with a focus on studying the geology of the lunar surface. To achieve this goal, Shepard and Mitchell spent 33 hours on the moon, conducting 2 moonwalks and collecting rock and soil samples. They also set up a variety of scientific experiments to study the lunar environment and interior. One of the most significant moments of the Apollo 14 mission was when Shepard hit 2 golf balls on the moon's surface, becoming the first person to play golf on the moon. This playful moment has since become an iconic symbol of the Apollo program and humanity's exploration of the moon. The rock and soil samples collected by Shepard and Mitchell provided valuable information about the moon's geology and history. The scientific experiments conducted during the mission added to our understanding of the moon's environment, including its magnetic field and the presence of helium-3, a rare isotope that could be used as fuel for future fusion reactors. the Apollo 14 mission was a major success and demonstrated the continued progress of the United States in the exploration of the Moon. The mission marked a crucial step in our understanding of the Moon's history and composition and paved the way for future manned missions to the lunar surface. Apollo 15 was the fourth manned mission to the Moon, and it took place in July of 1971. The crew of Apollo 15 consisted of Commander David Scott, Lunar Module Pilot James Irwin, and Command Module Pilot Alfred Worden. One of the main goals of the Apollo 15 mission was to perform a more extensive exploration of the Moon's surface, with a focus on scientific experimentation and geology. To achieve this goal, Scott and Irwin spent over 18 hours on the Moon, conducting three moonwalks and collecting rock and soil samples. They also used a Lunar Roving Vehicle, LRV, a specially designed vehicle that allowed them to travel greater distances on the lunar surface and collect more samples. One of the most significant moments of the Apollo 15 mission was when Scott and Irwin discovered a type of rock called a breccia, which indicated that the area where they were landing had been the site of a major impact. This discovery added to our understanding of the Moon's geology and history and showed that the Moon had a more violent past than previously believed. The rock and soil samples collected during the mission provided valuable information about the Moon's composition and history. The scientific experiments conducted during the mission, including the ALSEP package, added to our understanding of the Moon's environment, including its magnetic field and interior structure. Apollo 16 was the fifth manned mission to the Moon, and it took place in April of 1972. The crew of Apollo 16 consisted of Commander John Young, Lunar Module Pilot Charles Duke, and Command Module Pilot Thomas Mattingly. One of the main goals of the Apollo 16 mission was to perform a more extensive exploration of the Moon's surface, with a focus on scientific experimentation and geology. To achieve this goal, Young and Duke spent over 20 hours on the Moon, conducting three moonwalks and collecting rock and soil samples. Apollo 15 and 16 were similar missions, but there were also differences between them. Both missions focused on scientific experimentation and exploration of the Moon's surface, and both involved collecting rock and soil samples and using a Lunar Roving Vehicle, LRV, to travel greater distances on the lunar surface. One key difference between the two missions was the location of the landing site. Apollo 15 landed in the Hadley-Apennine region of the Moon, while Apollo 16 landed in the Descartes Highlands. The different landing sites offered the opportunity to study different types of lunar terrain and geology, and the samples collected from each mission provided unique insights into the Moon's composition and history. Another difference between the two missions was the duration of the moonwalks and the number of experiments conducted. Apollo 16 was the longest moonwalk to date, with Young and Duke spending over 20 hours on the Moon, while Apollo 15 had a moonwalk duration of over 18 hours. Additionally, Apollo 16 had a greater number of scientific experiments and instruments on the lunar module, and the crew of Apollo 16 had more training in geology than the crew of Apollo 15. Apollo 17 was the final manned mission to the Moon and took place in December of 1972. The crew consisted of Commander Eugene Cernan, Lunar Module Pilot Harrison Schmidt, and Command Module Pilot Ronald Evans. One of the main goals of the Apollo 17 mission was to conduct a comprehensive study of the Moon's geology and environment. To achieve this goal, Cernan and Schmidt spent over 22 hours on the Moon, conducting three moonwalks and collecting rock and soil samples. They also used a Lunar Roving Vehicle, LRV, to travel greater distances on the lunar surface and collect more samples. One of the most significant moments of the Apollo 17 mission was when Schmidt, who was a trained geologist, discovered a type of rock called orange soil. This discovery was significant because the orange soil was found to be rich in a mineral called titanium, which indicated that the area had once been the site of volcanic activity. This discovery added to our understanding of the Moon's geology and showed that the Moon had a more complex history than previously believed. The rock and soil samples collected during the mission provided valuable information about the Moon's composition and history. For example, the sample showed evidence of past volcanic activity and helped scientists determine the age of the Moon. The scientific experiments conducted during the mission, including the ALSEP package, added to our understanding of the Moon's environment, including its magnetic field and interior structure. The Apollo 17 mission was a major success and marked the end of the Apollo program. The mission demonstrated the technological capabilities of the United States and contributed greatly to our understanding of the Moon. The mission left a lasting legacy in the field of space exploration and paved the way for future missions to the Moon and beyond. Join us on the Fact Zone and discover a world of fun facts. Subscribe now and never stop learning something new every day.